Introducing these two super fight series warriors once again. The fighter standing in the blue corner, he weighed in at 69.6 kilograms. He represents Eagle Kick Boxing Academy. From Greece, he is George the Greco Koulalis. And standing across the ring in the red corner, this fighter weighed in at 69.9 kilograms. He represents Team Bad Boy and Bailey's Fitness Gym. He is Stuart Longston. Your referee in charge of action is Paul Nichols.
WKA British title action. And it's the Greco, George Koulalis from the Eagle Kickboxing Academy against Stuart Lumsden from Team Bad Boy with Jeremy Bailey there in the corner. And we know Lumsden previously, very explosive, forward fighter.
Lumsden has excellent boxing, really good body work in particular, and an excellent and proficient low kick game. His opponent tonight, the Greco, George Koulalis, really well-rounded. Watch out for those high kicks, lots of good lateral footwork. I'd expect Lumsden to try to stand a little bit more flat-footed, deliver power, and I would expect the Greco to try to move, stick, attack with low kicks, and possibly set up some of those high kicks that we've seen from him before.
Yes, Lumsden is a pressure cooker fighter. He's the taller of the two, but nice boxing now already from Koulalis. But Lumsden will continue to come forward. He really loves to put you under pressure, and he's got a very solid chin indeed as well.
Lumsden already pressing the issue. Solid jab, double jab to a right cross, and then finishing with that left hook. Watch him to move that left hook to the midsection. He kind of can read a pattern of him finishing that combination to the head and then to the body.
That was good movement from Koulalis because Lumsden was trying to guide him towards that right knee, but he slipped out the other way. And when he lets them go, Koulalis has got very fast hands, as you saw with that combination, Chris.
And that lateral footwork, the way he exits, is really slick. He's going to have to do it against a guy who likes to stand a little bit more flat-footed and throw power. And Lumsden.
Lumsden will throw like this all night long. He'll keep pressing the action, he'll keep pushing forward. But I like the way that Koulalis boxes on the counter. As you said, the lighter of the two men on his feet, good lateral movement, and then explodes into the counters every opportunity, just like that. Moves beautifully off that center line, Chris. Works the angles.
He does really well to sort of come in on those angles and then hang back when he knows that Lumsden is going to throw. Oh, nice right lands there for the Greco.
That's what he's good at. He moves, he shifts, and look at that. Tips your man off balance, moves slickly, and then fires the counters in.
Good frame. Koulalis has got to be in or out. You notice he kind of prefers his back to space at two steps out. Lumsden wants to corral him into the corners. Cut down that movement, use the geometry, work the square circle. Nice knee, but a short right lands, and Koulalis punishes Lumsden.
That impact was doubled because it was the movement of Koulalis doubled up with the forward motion of Lumsden, and Lumsden literally walked onto it, doubling that impact. And that's also the accuracy and the movement of Koulalis. And he'll go for the finish here, Chris.
Nice short knee there from Koulalis, and a kick again lands. No knockdown, says Paul Nichols. Lumsden on the ropes.
He'll keep coming forward. This is the thing with Lumsden. He'll try and fight his way out of this. It's not always the best tactic, but it's the way this man works. He comes forward, ready to throw again. I think he'll survive the round now, but it's a big round for Koulalis with the accuracy and that knockdown and those big knees now as well. Lumsden will be happy to hear that bell, Chris.
Lumsden is known as one of the most exciting guys at 70 kilograms on the British circuit. With good reason, he takes risks. He throws every single shot to knock you out. That being said, it was a smart performance from the Greco. George Koulalis getting a well-earned knockdown there in the first frame.
Speed, movement, accuracy, the three combined to generate the power that we saw in that round from the young Greek. Superb foot movement.
Let's take a look at some of the action here. Lumsden coming in very aggressive. Both guys throwing simultaneously there. And in the middle of the chaos, the Greco was able to dip his head and catch him with that short right. He didn't even fully extend on that punch. Lumsden ran clean into it.
That's right, he didn't need to. It was the timing. Lumsden coming forward, him timing it perfectly. And it's a big round for the man from Eagle Academy now, Chris. Lumsden, what I tell you now, will still come back and he'll still come forward and still throw the leather.
So another round on tap here. Lumsden looks to have really refreshed and recuperated himself.
And for Corrales, we'll see exactly the same as well, because he doesn't need to change his game plan. He's perfect tactically. He's so mobile, he's so accurate.
Nice exit there. Very, very slick. The ring generalship and awareness of Corrales is remarkable.
We have an old cliche, Chris. Make them miss, make them pay. This man puts that into action so fluidly.
And there's kind of a law of least effort about it as well. It's not like he's actually really forcing the issue. Whereas Lumsden is definitely trying to knock him senseless.
Solid defense is only half of the battle, and he has got good defense based on that wonderful movement. But what he does is, it's economy of movement. He does just enough to get out of the way, and that's why he can retaliate.
Better boxing here from Lumsden. I like him getting behind that jab and extending it to utilize it to full effect. He's got a good kicking game as well. I want to see him kick more off those boxing combinations.
He will continue to come forward. He likes the pressure. He likes to keep the pace going. He likes to keep working. But again, he's never sure which way Kalais is going to exit. And that's been the key for the group. He's
good work here from Lumsden. You can hear Jeremy Bailey, his coach, calling for him to reset, keep his hands up, reset, and then initiate off that jab when he feels comfortable.
So Corrales trying to shrug that off. Lumsden coming forward again, edging forward ever nearer. I like the way Corrales looks as if he's going to go defensively, then bursts forward with action. This is what Lumsden likes to do. He likes to ask us to be here. Move and then hit. Slip out of the way. The first time that Corrales has slipped and not thrown a counter.
Flying in is Lumsden. He's doing a better job of not overcommitting like he did last time. That got him into trouble. He's boxing with good technique and more intelligence.
Yes, and it's playing off for him. He's having success. And backed Kalais up there and got through with a nice heavy right. That increases confidence. Good exchange of kicks as well. Kalais not quite so keen to come forward now at the way Lumsden does it. Fluid combinations from the group.
I'd like to see him continue to use those kicks and go upstairs. He's shown the good kicks to the body. Thought about actually going over the guard there to Lumsden on that left kick. Just get it up a little bit higher and turn it up over the top of the guard. He might be able to catch Lumsden in that position.
That knee almost did this. It was slick, it was sweet. Lumsden saw it, but again, Corrales won't need to work Stuart Lumsden out. Stuart Lumsden will give you this for three rounds. So in a way, it makes Corrales' job easier. Because the five rounds, sorry, not the three. This is the and in a way, it does make Corrales' job easier.
Nice switch kick there from the Greco at the bell. A very intriguing stylistic matchup between two men who know only one thing, Malcolm, and that is entertainment.
Well, Stuart Lumsden, we can see his style. It's not hard to figure out, but he did utilize it better in this round. Got his timing better, got his distance better, and when he threw his shots, they were clean, and they did land pretty well. But I think Lumsden, he knows what Lumsden's going to bring to the table here, and he knows what he's going to do. And moving, so stylistically, it's a match made in heaven for him, as we see here, slips out the way, throws. And Stuart, what does he do? He goes straight back at him, which is bread and butter for the guard, Corrales.
Yeah, Corrales showed some excellent slips and rolls. Tough to do, especially when you're moving backwards and when you're worried about getting caught up the ropes. Lumsden, I think, was at his best when he jabs really long, that snap jab, not overcommitting like that, right? He's swinging so hard, he actually gets kind of in a position where he comes in too deep and allows Corrales the opportunity to escape. I like him when he jabs really long, doesn't come in too hard. Double jab,
maybe even double jab to a lead hook. And like you, I'd like to see him use his legs more as well against his shorter opponent, that mobility. Chop at the tree, chop at that foundation. Try and negate that mobility. He's still got three rounds to slow his man down. Then his power punch can really come into play.
Low blow there. An inside low kick. Slightly off sides.
Paul Nichols saying, I'm not so sure this time to George there. That's why he's allowing this to continue so quickly, saying, I'll give you the benefit of that, George, but it looked quite clean to me.
That's better from Corrales. He's got to use those really nice kicks that he has. Work the body, work the legs. And stay off the ropes.
Lemson's got that nice stiff jab. Those low kicks must come in far more frequently to stop this mobile man moving. As you alluded to earlier, his jab is good, his boxing is good, but he can't just rely on it, not against this man.
Nice check there from Corrales. He thought about going left, couldn't get it. He was worried about running that hook of Lemson, so he went right.
Right leg low, left leg high, then the left leg to the inside of the lead leg of Lumsden. Corrales turning up the heat again. Lumsden, he's got that dogged nature, Chris. He sticks to the plan, sucks up the shots, takes the nods, and then comes forward again. When it works brilliantly for him, but when it doesn't, you'd like to see maybe a plan B.
Nice switch kick. I like the way that Corrales sometimes kicks first before his punches.
He's always right, left, and then the same with his movement. He never just slip you one way. Lumsden can't sort of find a pattern to his work. And that's the problem. When you're a man who's got such a it's hard for when you're facing someone that is totally the opposite.
The old saying that styles make fights, and of course in a game plan or a strategy is you sort of evolve and rethink what you're doing throughout the contest. If there's something that your opponent can do that you don't have an answer for, that is to say, they can solve the problems that you pose at a faster rate, that can be the difference. Especially when you've got the full five rounds to play things out.
For me, for Stuart Lumsden, he works so hard at working. What he's got to try and do now is lure him to the right hand. It's a solid punch there. He's got to lure him better into the right hand. Corrales is so slick on the counter. But it's the right tactic this time from Lumsden. This is where he wants him, and he wants him moving. Corrales is now getting to the stage where he's also up to stand and trade with Stuart.
That for me is not as smart of a strategy as he used to probably win that first round.
There's one other reason possibly about the energy expended in those opening two rounds. It doesn't make it as easy for him to keep moving. For standing and trading, he also say, hey, he's been in a place for me because I've been on mobile, long mobile. Might be the first time the quality is slowing down. If it is, it really would suit Stuart Lumsden.
And this for me was one of the key things about this. Rounds two, rounds three, Lumsden was a lot more intelligent. Boxed his way forward, but didn't get over presumptuous about it. Really solid jab. I think this is actually even a better round for him than the last one. So I've got this fight tied up right now. It was a 10-8 round for Corrales because of that knockdown in the first. This leaves those last two rounds really an important thing.
But what we saw from that replay though, Chris, is what I was saying earlier. I would still like to see him follow up that good boxing with a few more low legs, a few more kicks, full stop, to get the same up and down rhythm that you see from George Corrales. So now, Chris, we will really see whether that mobility is starting to leave Corrales or if he's got his second win. If he's got a second win, it's a long, hard night for Lumsden.
Corrales has got to get back to that points fighting strategy that he used in the first round. He was able to catch Lumsden and nearly finish the fight. A lot of credit to Lumsden to come back like this, though.
This will suit Lumsden. As you said, the start of Kouliannis is acting now, although he could risk getting hurt or even knocked out. Lumsden will trade far better like this than earlier with that mobility of Kouliannis, not knowing whether it's going to go left or it's going to go right, hitting him on the turn.
And a quick halt to the action here. Neutral corners again.
That's because Jeremy Bailey's actually complaining strongly to Paul Nicholls that that one wasn't low. He's saying, no, ref, that wasn't low. Paul Nicholls, obviously the man in charge, telling Jeremy Bailey he'll handle this. But Jeremy really felt that that one wasn't low this time.
Fighters to the center. Great show of sportsmanship. I'm sure he wants to. You know, there's been a real frenetic pace to this fight. Those kicks can sometimes go off trajectory.
Well, I think Lumsden will get hard from this. This change in tactic from Corrales, he's more aggressive. He's sticking the head, but Lumsden prefers that. Lumsden will be like to be in this point in time, in the pocket, firing away like that, because as much as it's dangerous, it also gives him an opportunity to finish his opponent.
That lateral footwork is key. You never know which way he's going to exit. Tough for Lumsden to sort of time, especially when Corrales is so aware. When he runs out of space, he knows. He thinks, all right, I've got to go left, got to go right, got to watch out for the power. Lumsden trying to catch him there, but Corrales read the spin, flew in with that flying right hand.
And this is where, when Corrales initiates the conflict, he took that lead leg of Lumsden this time. Uppercut reply from Lumsden. Lumsden must maximize when they're this close. When they're in the pocket like this, that's when that boxing really must have a payoff here. But Corrales, the versatility, up and down, up and down, is frustrating Stuart Lumsden.
Well, there's less than a minute left here. Corrales has got to try to steal this round. This is really important here.
Lumsden continuing to pile on the pressure. The change in styles has slightly suited him now, and he's got more of a rhythm going. And I said, he'll take this to be able to fire back. Now, Corrales, you saw the accuracy, but Lumsden is comfortable with that. He'll fire back, he'll fire back, look for a good shot.
But the question is, in what has probably been the closest round of this fight? Oh, there's a huge right hand from Lumsden. That was also key. The question is, though, is do Corrales or Lumsden score more points here?
That's right. I just feel that the change in tactic from Corrales is opening the door for Lumsden, which I find strange. The tactic from the opening two rounds was very, very good indeed, but he can now see light, Stuart Lumsden.
Nice jab again. That jab is landing really nicely for Corrales. Lumsden's kind of reaching a little bit here.
And again, will walk forward, he'll throw the leg of Corrales looking for those knees. It makes for an interesting battle, it makes for a fun battle, and as you saw there, it's a very smart, very sporting battle, but Chris, are you surprised with Corrales' change of tactics?
Well, as they both touched gloves and Paul Nicholls was caught in the middle, both fighters know they've dragged each other into deep waters, and in some ways have kind of brought the very best out of each other. Well, what do I mean by that? On one hand, we saw Lumsden in early trouble. He rethought what he was trying to do and got back to a more intelligent approach. But Corrales, after a couple of rounds there in two and three, of not really being able to get going what worked so well in the first, fought a little bit smarter here. He made sure he kept his back to the center of the ring. You see him try to fight his way out there and actually go around the back. And he landed some good shots. This was probably the most competitive round. Championship round, the fourth round, and a close round.
But as I said to you earlier, Chris, it also actually suited Stuart Lumsden better. He was more comfortable with a more orthodox Corrales. Even though Corrales, as I said, was landing cleanly and smartly, Lumsden understood it better, was happy to stand and trade with him like that. And I think Stuart Lumsden will really try to force the pace here in the fifth. He's got to as well.
Third and final round here, 3 more minutes on the clock. Excuse me, fifth and final round. Sorry, it's been a long night here tonight at the Super Fight Series. WKA British title on the line. Chris Hoekstra with you, alongside my partner, as always, Malcolm Martin. Thank you very much for tuning in. The number one kickboxing show in the UK. Super Fight Series 4, the masterpiece.
And here they go. Both men at it now. They realize the importance of this round. And as I said to you, Lumsden likes this sort of fight. This will suit him down to the ground. It shows the confidence of Gularis as well, but Stuart Lumsden will really fancy this final round now. And Gularis backing off, throwing the left and right, but this is playing into the hands of Lumsden. Lumsden throws the heavy left and right hooks, growing in confidence in this fifth round now.
This last round is going to be key. Lumsden tied up in the fourth.
And now Gularis switches again to the leg kicks, forcing Lumsden to check, sticking and moving again and throwing the kicks, forcing Lumsden to try and walk him down once more, as he did in the opening two rounds, Chris.
Lumsden would be smart to continue to try to pot shot at Gularis and not come in so hard. If he can score enough points here, he could steal this.
And again, every time that Gularis goes for that low kick, he's got to shoot that punch out or his own kick out. I think Stuart Lumsden will regret not kicking just a little bit more to the legs of this mobile man, just like that.
This is what I'm saying. At this point, Lumsden has to think, I haven't been able to get this guy out of here yet. Keep dropping him first. If I can box him, rack up the points, kick the legs, and control the ring, that could be enough to edge out the round. Not much time left, though.
No, and Gularis working. Look at the inside of the thigh of Lumsden there, working that leg systematically. But stylistically, for me, Gularis has shown he's got everything here, because he's shown how mobile he can be. He's shown he can be elusive, but he's also said to Lumsden, I can stand and trade in the trenches.
Yeah, he scored a few really clean shots in the last 60 seconds. It's been single punch exchanges, really, single kick exchanges for Gularis. Look at that, one kick backs up, comes up, pivots away, punches, kicks again.
That lead leg of Lumsden has been peppered by that left lead leg, but Lumsden doesn't matter, he knows it's the fifth, he doesn't care, he's coming forward, he needs to throw those heavy leather, he'll take those shots to the leg to try and get there, but I've just got a feeling this fifth round is key, and that if it stays like this, George Gularis is going to take this title.
Inside low kick, snap tap there from Gularis, the Greco. And Lumsden continue to tango here.
There you go, superb finish in the back. Five high octane rounds, Chris. Stuart Lumsden, as we thought, stuck to the game plan. He's so tough, he's so fit, and he's so consistent. But I think he's come against a man technically superb, very clever in his thinking. I've got a feeling the Greco is going to take this title.
Both fighters really stayed active throughout this contest. Nobody took a break, nobody took a round off, and it was massive to be able to see Lumsden get rocked like that in the first comeback, start to dominate the fight on his terms. But the last couple of rounds were as competitive as we had seen all night. The Greco may be edging the last frame on our scorecards here. Will it be enough to win the title? We're gonna find out momentarily. Judges are really carefully checking those scores. Grant Waterman's got the announcement. It looks like the result is in now. Can we hear some final highlights?
Yes, and as you see from those final highlights, Lumsden stuck doggedly to his plan. And Gularis kept us entertained by switching. Sometimes he would stand and trade, other times he would move. But in that fifth and final round, he peppered that lead leg of Lumsden. And that could be key as well as we go to Grant Waterman for the official announcement.
Ladies and gentlemen, after five fantastic rounds of championship action, we go to the judges' scorecards. And we have a unanimous decision in favor of your winner and new WKA British champion, Georgios!
He took the fight in that first round. The count was key, and rounds four and five, when he stood and traded with Lumsden and peppered that lead leg, also proved vital to him.
It was a valiant effort from both guys. Championship fighting here tonight on the Super Fight Series. Excellent matchmaking. It was a very intriguing contest. And a lot of credit to Lumsden for the comeback from that first round, having to go through the worst moments of the bout for him and come back in spades. The adaptation, though, from the Greco was a little bit too much in the end. Ladies and gentlemen, your champion and new George Gularis.